fancy meeting you alone in the crowd. Couldn't help but notice your smile while everybody else around us is going about. Can we just stop and talk a while? And told our world's growing old, and that friends are harder to find. To tell me more about yourself, we could share a thought or two.
Afternoon's gonna be yours.
Yes.
Yes. Government House is gonna be yours. It's not gonna be mine. It's yours. You can take ownership of this election, and the victory of this election belongs to you, not to me and Jerry or Gary and Super. This is ours, all. If you understand that, it gives you more to go out there and make sure that you do the darndest and the utmost that you can do. Not just say, okay, I got 5 votes. No, you go get the other 10. Those people that you know, you can take to the polls and convince. I'm saying, ladies and gentlemen, that this is the chance that we have. I don't think, you'll probably see me in 2018 again when we win. But if we don't take this one along, I'm saying that right now, it's the people that's going to suffer. Not me, not Jerry. The people are going to suffer with programs that nobody knows what's going on. We have been borrowed up to the ceiling. And we cannot borrow anymore. And the only way he can borrow more is to raise the real estate tax, which he's doing. He's going to double your real estate tax. And then he's going to raise it even more by taxing the Chamorro Land Trust properties. And besides that, he's going to go in there and figure out how to take your property away because you missed one tax payment. Never been done in 30 years. But he's doing it. He's doing it because he needs to raise up the ceiling so he can borrow more. It's dangerous. Believe me, he doesn't care. Once he does all that and pays all of his cronies, he's going to leave office. And he doesn't care who has to take care of the debts. Just look at it as your own and the household. You don't keep borrowing and then they foreclose your house. And I keep coming across this, the couple told me that they're going to vote for him because he gave us the refund. I said, didn't he promise you that he's going to give you your refund in 2010? He said, yeah. Okay, and you voted for him? He said, yeah. Okay, finished already, right? He gave you a refund. You voted for him. Now what's he offering you for 2014? We're going to give you a refund again when the court already said you have to give the refund. So he does see that they don't know. That argument is, what is he offering you and your children and your grandchildren for the future? Not just the fact that, hey, I kept my promise for 2010. No, that's not enough. What are you going to do for 2014, 2015 on? And they're not getting that answer from him. But the more you press the issue, the more people realize that this team is all about getting in now and worrying about the layoffs in January, February, March, later. That's what's going to happen. It's going to be a downsizing of the government. There's going to be furloughs. There's going to be a limited hours work. There's not going to be any supplies in the schools. The police officers are not going to get their equipment. They're not going to get another car for the police department. That's not their plan. Their plan is just to pretend that they can get by. Get by. Man, I'm telling you, if you were Calvateri standing up here, think about it. I'm going to go out there and find everybody that I know on the earth that can vote, and I'll make sure that they vote. Cast that vote, because if you miss one, that could be the decision-making one. So for now, from the room and then is on me just the election, me just the, not me and Jerry. We're just the instrument here with Gary. It's your election. Treat it as yours. Take ownership. Because when we win, we all march to Adelup together, not just me and Jerry and Gary. Thank you.
You know, we're all being fired up. We're all energized. So we're going to work very hard, right? Today is Tuesday. We have Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, and Saturday's election. So are we all going out there and we're going to get all our friends and family to go and vote, right? Yeah. All right. And And please do us a favor, all of us here, please make sure that your family goes out and votes early. Remember, we always have a poll. People, the media will come out and says, how many have voted and where, who, you know, who did you vote for? So we can always say that Guterres is leading.
Call for your attention and for a little bit of quiet every once in a while. It's quite all right. Anyway, I know that a lot of you just came straight from work and you must be very, very, like my grandson would say, very, very starving. But we have a little bit of merienda. It's not a full-on meal. I'm inviting everybody and thanking everybody whose generosity, you know, made the little bit of snacks happen. Please join me in 17. You make